a quick demonstration to introduce you to the blend tool. I'm not really gonna use it for color. I'm gonna more use it to add lines and to have them space out evenly. So I'd like to show you that trick. And then I'm also gonna show you how to make a pattern brush to make your elastic, the little shearing from the elastic. Now to get started, it's come to my attention that not everybody is using a mouse. Make sure you're drawing with a mouse and not the trackpad on your laptop. This will make your life a million times easier. Please, 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 please. Some of you guys maybe have a Wacom tablet. These are kind of expensive, so I realize not everyone's gonna have that. That's acceptable as well, but do not use your finger on the trackpad or you're really gonna struggle. And so it's worth paying $10. Sorry, please do it. Okay, enough of my lecture. Okay, so here we go. I have my pair of pants kind of started. Again, we're trying to draw this CAD, so I'm gonna focus in on the elastic waistband. So I'm gonna zoom in here, I hit the letter Z, I'm gonna hit the space bar to pan. Well, actually, when I look here, it looks like she's gonna have three stripes of elastic, little squiggle lines. So I'm gonna wanna mimic that as well. So to do that, I think what I wanna do is actually evenly space out my waistband into three even rows. So to do that, I'm gonna use the blend tool. So I'm gonna select the bottom here. I hit the letter A to get to the white arrow. I'm gonna click one of those anchor points. I'm gonna hold shift, get the other guy. I'm gonna hold shift and get these two as well. I'm gonna say command C, command V, just to kind of bring it up here so you guys can watch me do this. I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of my fill color. I don't need that. Okay, so I want to have three spaces. So I believe if I put in two lines in the middle, that will make three spaces, right? If you make a mistake, you can always change it. So what you have to do is go Object, Blend. Okay, well, we can do Make or Blend options. Maybe I'll just go ahead and hit Make. Okay, so that's not what I want, right? That's too many. So there is, I can go back to options, or there is a tool over here on your menu that's usually always over there. Just double click it and I can change the steps. Right now it has three steps. I actually only want two, and make sure you're on specified steps. This is where you can do color, that didn't really work, steps, and then distance. There's other options. Okay, but I don't want to do the math, so I'm not going to put in distance. I just want it split evenly into three segments, which I guess equals two steps. Sure. Okay, so I just have that. So now I can kind of zoom in and attempt to draw my little squiggle lines. You can definitely use the pen tool for the squiggle lines, but I do want them to be kind of like messy and organic, so I'm going to use the pencil tool. I don't normally talk about the pencil tool. I keep it on the down low. I don't want students to really know about it because I want you guys to master the pen tool. So, okay, I hit the letter N and it did bring up my pencil. So I'm just gonna kind of click and drag like a little arc. Okay, right away, I'm not happy with my stroke. I think it's too wide. I'm just gonna change it to like 0.5 and see what that does. That was a little long. I don't know, I guess I could hit the letter A and bring it up because I want my squiggle to kind of fit in here. I'm gonna hit the letter N. Now the problem with the pencil is that if you draw next to something, sometimes it changes it. In this case, it's not really doing that, so I'm kind of lucky. If that happens, you can just lock the thing you just drew so it won't change it. Okay, so oops, maybe this is enough. Let me see, I'm gonna do kind of a straight one. Okay, so maybe this is a good pattern, and then I just want to repeat this. So I'm going to select these guys. I'm just going to move them here. I highly recommend making sure you're happy with your alignment because I was kind of working at a tilt. So I'm just going to play with my align tools. I'm going to kind of center them in the middle. Let's see if I like it. If I don't, I can always hit edit undo. I don't think I like it. Command Z. I'm going to leave it kind of more tossed. This bottom one's a little bit low. I think I'm going to bring it. Oh, I'm going to zoom in. Letter Z. Panning with the space bar, letter V, I think. Okay, maybe I'll move him. Maybe I'm being too picky, I don't know. Command negative, control negative if you're on a PC. Okay, so I'm gonna turn this into a pattern so I don't have to draw those squiggle lines, a couple hundred of them. So I'm gonna open up my brushes. If it's not already open, just go up to the window. It's all alphabetized, which is kind of nice. So B for brushes. It looks like this file already has a bunch. So let's see here. So I'm just going to go ahead and click and drag and drop it in. Do you see that little green plus sign? That's a good sign. I have some choices. I honestly don't use the scatter brush really ever, so I'm not going to talk about that. Art brush we do use when we make our drag lines. It's kind of like a paintbrush where you start and then drag it so it like stretches your brush. I don't want this stretched. I want it repeated. So a pattern is perfect. It's going to like tile repeat it for me. So choose pattern. Okay. We have a big window of options that come up. It kind of just put together a corner. Luckily, I'm not going to make any corners, so I don't really care. You're welcome to play around with all these options to see what they do, but I will tell you the most important one is going to be the colorization. Defaults to none, which means it'll always stay black. So even when you go over here and change your stroke to a different color, your artwork, little squiggle lines, will always be black. Maybe that's good. If you want the option to change color, just choose tints and you should be good. I'm going to say okay. Okay, cool. Let's see if I can move this a little bit smaller. It's kind of large and in charge. Okay, there we go. It's down at the bottom. Oh, I made two earlier, so ignore those two. Good times. Okay, so I'm going to delete them. I don't need those. And now what do I want to do? Okay, why don't I try putting them in here? So the blend tool, it's not totally perfect, but I'm going to show you what's what. Okay, so right now I have two lines. I'm going to change it to three, okay? So I guess I'll double click, 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 and I'll change my steps to three. Okay, so I would like each of those three things to be one of my squiggle lines. But right now I can't really access it with any of my arrows because I can only touch the blend tool. So what I want to do is I want to select this guy, and I'm going to go back to Object, Blend, and I'm going to say Expand. So now do you see there's like, if they're, all the lines are highlighted, so it's not like all grouped together in the blend tool. It is grouped together, but I can actually access it. So if I use just a white arrow, I can select them. If I use the black arrow, letter V, it selects all of them because it's been grouped. So hopefully by now you have control over the group tool. I can double click to temporarily ungroup stuff. You can always go, I just double click to get out of that. You can also go Object, Ungroup as well, and it'll ungroup it as well permanently. So maybe I'll do that. Okay, so I don't want the top and the bottom. That's just like the edge of my pant. And then I'll take these three and I'll choose my little thing. Okie dokie, that's kind of a lot of stitches. I hope it's not too black. I can always go in and change it if I need to, but I'm gonna bring this on down and put it there. Okay. And I don't think my blending tool really worked perfectly, to be honest with you. I don't know. I'm kind of playing around with here. Even put this one back where it was. So now, I kind of wish I didn't delete it. But anyways, I can make another one. Because I want to add my straight lines for my little stitching details. So I'm going to select this. I'm going to hold Shift. I'm picking all these white points with my white arrow. Command-C, Command-V. V for the black arrow. Bring it up. Gonna get rid of that fill color. I'm gonna do the blend tool again. So Object, Blend, Make. This time I only want two. So I'm gonna double click here, change the steps to two and say okay. And then again, I'm gonna say Object, Blend, Expand. And then I'm gonna the letter V. And this time I'll double click, click, click. I'm gonna delete the edges. I don't really need them. And I'm gonna take this middle one and I'm gonna put it down here in between my stitches, and then I'm going to change it to a dashed line. Do you guys remember how to do dashed lines? Sometimes there's brushes for them, but I prefer to use the stroke palette. So if your stroke is not already open, you can always go to window, scroll down to the S's, there's stroke, and go ahead and look for dashed line, and you can choose. I like 3x2, that usually is pretty good for me. It is a stitch, maybe just 0.5 is fine. And I can zoom in here and just try to get these rows like cleaned up a little bit. I think that they're just spaced a little funny. I tried to use my blend tool, but I don't know. I just feel like that I didn't like the way it looked. So the spacing, I still feel like the spacing was off. Zoom in again. Space bar to pan, letter V for the black arrow. Okay, cool. Command zero. Okay, so there we go. So I have some stitches. They are kind of loud though, right? They're a little bit, what? I don't know. So what should I do? Should I, let's go here. I'm going to select it. I'm going to double click this guy. Is there anything I can do here? Spacing? No, not really. I'm going to say cancel. I could change the colors, or I could, I'm going to pull it out. I'm going to delete that. This was my, they put a clear box. Did you guys see that when I pulled it out of the thing? I'm going to delete the clear box. I don't think I need it. Okay. I could change it. It's at 0.5. Maybe I change the stroke to only 0.25, or maybe that's too thin. Maybe I change it to like 0.35. Am I being too picky? I do that. Okay, so I'm going to hit the black arrow. I'm going to select it. I'm going to put it back in, and let's see if I like this thickness better. Pattern brush. Okay. I'm going to change my colorization. Oh, dear. Okay. Change the colorization to tints and say okay. Okay, now I'm going to select these. I'm going to hit the letter A this time, holding shift. Oops, I didn't get it. I got the little thing on the back. And okay, got them. And I'm going to pick the new one. I'm going to hit Command Zero to look far away. I think I do like that better. Command Z. Okay. So if it is still a little black, you know, another trick sometimes I do is I change the color. So instead of black, I might kind of change it to like a dark gray. And maybe that's a little bit better. I'm not sure. Okay, cool. So there you have it. That's how I like to make my elastic. Now that I look at these stitch lines, I'm like, I'm going to change it to like 2 by 1. How's that? Is that cuter? That's how I make my stitches with the brush. So let me know if you guys have any questions or suggestions.